Hello and welcome to a 2v2 cast. Starting off, we have Adeptus Noobus playing as the Warlock, also known as Morgan MLGman. Not even going to try and pronounce how he pronounces this name. And also for blue team, we have Adila playing as the Lord General. For the red team, we have Gom playing as the Force Commander and Reacts question mark playing as the Lord Commissar versus Reacts trademark in the chat. So I'm going to assume that the user interface can't show the trademark icon in the corner. Sign off, we have a nice bright orange sentinel moving in here, going to be meeting up some guardsmen. It's going to be an IG mirror on this left hand side, meanwhile on the right hand side, going to be an Eldar versus Space Marines matchup. But straight away the sentinel is going in, bit of action going on here between Dire Avengers and Scouts, actually ignoring each other for now, but the sentinel taking quite a bit of damage here, really down to just 280 HP, will be forced back away, and the sentinel here for Adila will also be able to chase down. The sentinel is actually going to be going down in the very first engagement, or before the first engagement. Well, it is technically the first engagement, but we'll be going to be going down, and Adeptus going to be coming in here with his Warlock, going to be landing a special on the Guardsman, or failing to land a special on the Guardsman, has already used his Destructor as well, and will be chasing them away. Meanwhile, on this right-hand side, the Banshees are coming in, Dire Avengers have already been forced off, a second set of Dire Avengers are mid, and doing some capping, but the Banshees going to get forced off here. Meanwhile, the Warlock is still chasing down, the Lord Commissar is extremely low himself, and will be going down here. Range attack from the Warlock should be enough to finish him down. In fact, Adila is actually going to be able to finish him off with the Sentinel, although the Warlock might be going down, but it should be an easy res for the Lord General. He is a very tanky commander in the very first engagement, given that he has a retinue to also tank for him, 950 HP of a commander armor. And the Warlock is able to actually get resurrected here in this engagement, and Lord General is going to be hitting level 2 because of that res. And Force Commander now making his way towards mid, going to be trying to chase down some Dire Avengers. His Bolt Pistol extremely effective at picking off these models as well, doing 16 DPS. Chainsword even more effective if he's actually able to get those melee swings in here, but should be able to pick off a model here. Could be even pick off a second model if he doesn't retreat his Dire Avengers here. Shotgun Scouts also coming in, Banshees are still in the base, Guardian Weapons team is now coming out on the field of Dire Avengers, now down 2 models, down 3 models. Our Force Commander is really picking away a few models there and has gained quite a lot of XP from doing so. Meanwhile, on this left hand side, Guardsmen going to be gained very low here, and Adila pushing in extremely aggressive here, denying the power there to red team. The Force Commander is here behind some green cover, using his Bolt Pistol, actually picking up Dire Avenger models behind that green cover, where he's now just out of range. The maximum range is about where this blue square is appearing. The Force Commander is going to be making his way back. Should be a fairly easy resurrection here on the Lord Commissar. He's actually down underground here, and should be able to give the Force Commander enough XP to level up to level 2. Sentinel is going to be repurchased here as well for Reacts. And Gom says okay to that res, and Devastators will be moving towards mid here for Gom. Adila's Guardsman getting a little bit low here. The Sentinel wigging out there a little bit, needs to be very careful not to get path blocked on those Guardsmen, and Warlock is getting suppressed here, but will be able to get outside the arc just in time. Those Dire Avengers taking a lot of damage here. In fact, those Dires might go down here. 20 HP on retreat, 2 HP on retreat. Warlock is actually able to tie up that Devastator squad before they're able to even finish off that Dire Avenger squad. Sentinel very far forward here again for Reacts, and I think that he is actually going to lose it if he's not careful. He is repairing it now and should be able to get it out there just in time. Meanwhile, Gom going for those fully upgraded scouts. Sentinel down 60 HP. Adila Sentinel is trying to chase, will not be able to get the chase down though, and the Force Commander is going to get res onto that Lord Commissar. Meanwhile, on the right hand side, Banshee is going to be backing away. Do get that aspect of strength, but Shotgun Scouts in the area. The Shotgun Blast is on cooldown as far as I'm aware, but the grenade is available. But landing a grenade onto Banshees, who are leaping into combat rather than melee charging in, gets a little bit more tricky. Spotter is going to get purchased for Reacts, good idea, given that there are a lot of Guardsmen on the field, a lot of range damage, pretty much purely range damage actually from Adila, unless he wants to use the Lord General in melee. So the Spotter's smoke shell will come in very nice in combination as well with the actual artillery shell itself to actually knock all the Guardsmen away and do a lot of damage as well in an area. Come tier 2, you can always upgrade them as well with the incendiary shell upgrade, which will immolate an area and will also be very effective against the Guardsmen as well. And Storm Shield is going to be purchased here from GOM. That Guided Weapons team is not going to be able to suppress the army here. Shotgun Blast is available for these scouts, and Shotgun Blast is going to be knocking back that Warlock. Force Commander is going to be able to brute force his webs. That Guided Weapons team, meanwhile, mid Adila's guardsman gained very low. The Lord General himself is going to be going down. The Commissar is also going to go down. Both commanders down on the ground. Guardsman retreats in the way. Guardsman here, though, full reacts, going to be able to push in. Meanwhile, on the right side, GOM able to push in here. Shotgun Scouts and attacks are going to bash. Devastate's going to reset up. The Lord Commissar is going to get resurrected here by the Force Commander. By the looks of things, he is on his way towards mid. Devastator is going to be setting up here. Very grouped up here, GOM, but there are no grenades available here for Morgan MLGman. Or Adeptus Noobus, I should really pick a name to actually call him rather than keep on switching between both. But the Commissar is going to get rezzed once again by that Force Commander, who is now level 3. The extra level is going to be helping out so much, given that he has the Storm Shield, the extra energy, the extra 10 energy that he gets per level, really coming in extremely handy, allowing him to use that Storm Shield a lot more. And there's even a Webway Gate going to be going down here as well for a sneaky bash. But GOM, having sent his scouts and tactical marines back to his natural power farm, so actually defended badge, he should be able to get at least one generator, although with how slow GOM's army is moving, potentially two generators even. Storm Shield can get set up, protect those Devastators from getting suppressed. They'll be able to suppress that Guardian Weapons team in return. In fact, they're going to be focusing down these Dire Avengers, both armed now with the aspects of the Avenger, both have plasma grenades available. Meanwhile, in mid, Guardsman, the Sentinel. Lord General is still dead on the ground. Guardsman still out the fight there for Adila. Meanwhile, on the right side, Devastator is going to get four soft dead. Grenades have been enough. The Warlock is also coming in for a resurrection there onto the Lord General. Guardsman not going to have enough DPS to knock down that Warlock. The artillery spotters could actually use their abilities to get the commander away there from the resurrection, but don't actually do that. Commissar is also coming in, and here comes a shell, which will actually end up missing. It is a smoke shell, though, which will prevent Adeptus from moving in any further. That Sensor is getting extremely low. Really needs to pull it out. Gain some last second repairs. Commissar is going in. There's the Sentinel. Will be going down. The repairs were not enough. And a nice spot shot going to be knocking down those Dire Avengers, but could have done with that a second earlier. I don't know if that was on cooldown or if that was not. Scouts could actually throw a grenade here, but they don't actually have the grenade available. Otherwise, they might have been able to get a few Dire Avenger models there in the end. And that Webway Gate is still in that bottom right hand side corner, still not used yet. Dilla is also coming in here with his Sentinel, level 2 Sentinel as well, and players are now hitting tier 2. GOM is the last person to tier 2, who is nearly done with it though. And very annoyingly, the power node is going to get repurchased here. Dilla having some guardsmen here for a counter bash at the same time, but no flamers on those guardsmen. Ideally, you don't want to buy the flamers unless you can guarantee an entire generator bash. Otherwise, you're stuck with the flamers on your guardsmen forever. Devastator is in a defensive position, ready to intercept Slumber Scouts and Tactical Marines. Banshee's going to be fleeting away here, going to not reveal the gate, in fact. Scouts going to throw a grenade hit. Right, I thought I saw them throw a grenade. I don't know what happened to that grenade, though. The grenade failed to actually kill any Banshee models. And also now the Exarch has been purchased as well, and the Banshee is revealed to GOM. Adeptus is now tier 2 as well, and Chimera is also set up in mid. Manticore is going to be the follow-up purchase here for Adila. And Guardsman going to be fighting Guardsman on the left-hand side. Lord Commissar has been upgraded with the Aura of Discipline, giving him a health boost. Not health boost, but a health regen aura for nearby allied units and himself as well. It doesn't affect himself, I don't think, but it does affect his Ogryns, keeping them separate away from all the guardsmen, keeping the Commissar very close to those Ogryns and keeping everything else away, giving these Ogryns so much health regen. And these guardsmen here for Adila going to get caught out here, but the Manticore strike is going to be coming in onto the guardsmen here of Reacts, and guardsmen not reacting at all. Ogryn's going to get caught out as well, and Adila's guardsmen going to have a free path to actually run through here. The guardsmen so low here, down to 74 health. Banshee's going to be coming out the gate here for a double. And the Ogryns are going to be using their charge. It means they can't use their ranged weapons, but it does give them a knockback and also gives them extra speed. In fact, the Exarch might go down here. If the Exarch takes one more melee hit, she would go down, but the Exarch is going to live. Chimera is coming in for some support. Meanwhile, GOM pushing in through mid. Guardsmen here going to get forced off, I'd imagine. Ogryns trying to do what they can. On 3 out of 4 models, that Aura of Discipline really giving them a lot of health back so far. And the Guardsmen are going to be forced off. Maybe they should actually enter this Chimera and get the Chimera to drive away. The Ogryns now switching focus towards the Sentinel. The Ogryns' range damage is actually fairly decent, so they should actually be able to chase down that Sentinel. Or force it back to base at the very least. I'm going to be upgrading his second set of tactical marines here to Standard veterans, using those damage over time rounds very effective against Eldar, since they consist mainly of infantry. But the Ogryn still chasing down the Sentinel. Meanwhile, the Commissar is trying to force melee onto the Guardsman here. The Guardsman as well. Plasma's gun's going to be coming in here for Adila. Sentinel is going to go down. Plasma gun's going to be very effective against the Ogryn, since they are super heavy infantry. Piercing damage really doesn't do well against super heavy infantry, whereas Plasma does do extremely well. And the Guardsman here for Reacts going to be forced off for more Guardsmen coming in here from the bottom. Spotters have gone down here for Reacts as well. Storm Shield is still here on that Force Commander, but no extra armor on that Force Commander. I think the Artificer's armor would work out really well in combination with that Storm Shield. The extra health regen and energy would be so useful. Grenade is going to disrupt that Guardian weapons team, but the Stand Guards and Devastators are going to sit very statically here. Storm Shield now turned off here. That Guardian weapons team behind an energy shield going to be immune from range damage, and the Storm Shield is now turned back on once again. Stand Guard veterans going to get tossed here. They actually do retreat away. The Force Commander with a domino knockback, actually knocking back a couple of models. One Devastator model even got knocked further forward there. Meanwhile, the left-hand side, the Chimera has actually gone to go down, surprisingly, to the Ogryns by the looks of things, or the Heavy Weapons team. Heavy Weapons team with the last cannon looks like it's going to be now taken down, along with the dead Ogryn next to that Chimera that you can see there. But the Sniper Rifle now for the Lord General, going to give these Guardsmen extra range. Ogryns coming back out of base, I would imagine, fairly soon, waiting for that last model. The Commissar is going to be engaging early, doesn't actually have any weapon or armor upgrades. Gom is also here on this right-hand side, this left-hand side, sorry. Dire Avengers also going to be jumping in from the fight from the right hand side. Guardsmen going to be focusing down. Commissar is also going to engage himself. Level 3 Commissar. Force Commander now level 4 as well after his engagement against the Eldar as well. The Commissar is going to be sprinting in here, somewhat unwise, since his backup is a little bit further away than it should be. Nadilla still needs to actually cap his natural VP as well at the same time. Devastator is going to be setting up. Gom extremely grouped up here in this very tight little circle. Just needs to be wary that there is a Manticore available for Adila. Manticore Strike, in fact, is actually going to go down. Don't know where it's going to go. It's actually going to hit Gom. It's going to hit everyone, in fact. Or try and hit everyone at the very least. Does actually get one missile hit onto Gom. And Terminator Force Commander already queued up here for Gom. That energy shield is going to be going down, but the Terminator armor is a very interesting thing to actually rush towards. Second person to go tier 2, or tier 3, sorry, is Adeptus as well. But Gom really rushing for tier 3. In fact, the only thing he spent in tier 2 was on the Stand Guard veterans and the sergeant as well, as a prerequisite as well for getting those Stand Guards. The Lord General kind of ignoring his guardsmen here, did give them the sniper rifle buff, but that sniper rifle buff doesn't really matter. These Ogryns going to be charging in here with that Aura of Discipline buff, not even taking any damage really at all. And Commissar going to be healing them back up to full health. And here's that Terminator Force Commander out on the field, already upgrading himself to the Assault Cannon as well. The Assault Cannon does actually suppress, or does do courage damage rather, so you can have the potential to suppress if you get enough courage damage onto an enemy. But going to be sitting very aggressively here. Darvin just trying to push in for a grenade, actually able to throw down a grenade. Devastators forced to run away, but the Stand Guard veterans and tactical marines are still here. Dragonfire rounds, the ones that are effective against units behind cover, are going to be used here, but unable to actually fire back as they're getting suppressed. And Dark Reapers doing inferno damage, very effective against heavy infantry. Banshees now with the distort field turned on, but going to be fighting this Terminator Force Commander, who just pops the Exarch with a single punch there. In fact, he will easily win that fight. He's going to be picking up multiple models here. He gets another melee swing, that's another model down on these Banshees, but unable to actually do so, decides to go for the VP instead. Meanwhile, Reacts actually pushing against the generator farm here of Adila, able to actually take it down with the Ogryns and Guardsmen, and forced to retreat away now because he has overstayed his welcome. But getting that generator farm away from blue team now might make tier 3 a little bit harder here for Adeptus, and tier 3 even harder as well for Adila, since he doesn't actually have as much power stored up. And Reacts himself are going to be going tier 3 as well. Manticore still in the field, I've not actually seen a Manticore strike from him yet. But then I have not paid much attention or as much attention to this left hand side. Sniper Rifle going to be doing a little bit of damage to these Devastators, but Warp Throw is going to be coming in here. Devastators unable to retreat away in time, grenades could get thrown down here. Manticore Strike is also going down as well. In fact, there's a Manticore sniping a Manticore here. Adila's Manticore getting sniped there by Reacts. Very nice job there. don't know how he had vision, must have used a Commissar flare in order to gain vision of it, but the Terminator Force Commander is going in here. He is taking so much damage in order to actually try and get in there, but that special is actually knocking back all the guardsmen there. The domino effect from knockback is going to be pretty painful. P-Dev's also going to be firing, but it's going to be landing slightly short. The Dire Avengers are pushing in very aggressively here, as if they got enough energy to throw a grenade. Problem is, they don't actually have enough energy to throw such a grenade. One squad did actually have enough energy just about towards the retreat, but the second squad only having 30 energy when you need 60 energy to throw that plasma grenade on your Dire Avengers. But some Kaskin's going to be coming out here for Adila, going to be upgrading to the plasma gun as well. Really wants to force those Ogryns off the field by the looks of it, and also very effective against Gom's army, which consists a lot of heavy infantry as well. And They Shall Know No Fear is getting used here on the Sand Guard. Veteran's going to have a 50% special chance against these Banshees, and they're getting forced off, and the grenade going to the scouts very close as well. Two of those Stern Guards will be able to wipe those Banshees out completely. But the Inferno damage from Dark Reaper is going to be effective against the Ogryns as well, and the Plasma Guns on the Guardsmen and Kaskin's going to be very effective against these Ogryns, who are currently unsupported right now, are backing away. That Manticore is mid, I don't know what this is doing, but it does need to go all the way back to base, and needs to be careful that there might be a little bit of friendly fire damage here from the Heavy Weapons team as well. But a Rocket Run onto that Manticore is going to be able to finish it off, and another Rocket Run, double Rocket Runs everywhere, that's something dead there. Adila going to have all his squads alive. Meanwhile, for Reacts, he's actually going to lose a squad himself. I'm not sure what squad he lost. Oh, it wasn't the Commissar. What did he lose then? I'm sure I saw a dead squad on the ground, and I can't remember what else he had. But double Rocket Runs, that was very difficult to actually keep track of. The Guardsmen onto this left-hand side, going to get melee down here by the Lord General. Without the Commissar upgrade, these Guardsmen cannot win in melee whatsoever. The Commissar really does help out the squad a lot. He does about 20 melee DPS roughly. That is an extremely rough figure. He does a lot of both melee and range damage though. 240 VPs to 319. Currently a triple cap here for red team. Blue team do need to start making their way and start capping. And Avatar is going to be coming out as well for Adeptus, that can be used as a line breaker unit. And allow them to push in through mid. Dire Avengers though, getting forced off on that right hand side, forced off the VP, forced off the requisition point. That PDEV shot though, extremely painful, taking out the Exarch for the Dark Reapers and taking down two models at the same time, nearly wiping the entire squad in fact. And Ogryn's going to be engaging here, going to be walking past those guardsmen coming in here, sniper rifle buffers coming in. The Ogryn's backing out a little bit early there, I think. They did have another 600 HP, could have stayed in the fight for a few more seconds. And in fact, the Bonehead is actually going to go down on retreats as well. Very unfortunate there for Reacts. Really needs his Commissar back as well for the aura of discipline support for his Ogryns. And some mines going to be placed down. Adila having no detectors at the moment for the Emperor used onto these P-Devs. Actually misfiring there though, and Guardsmen are going to be taking a lot of damage. P-Devs still not firing. Meanwhile, Gom pushing in against this generator farm on the right, and P-Devs going to fire away at the Guardsmen now, but the Guardsmen trying to get outside the arc there of those P-Devs. One Guardsman squad going to be forced off. The Lord General going to be the target here, and he will be able to get away just fine. The Guardsmen coming in for a flank, going to get flanked by some more Guardsmen though, and P-Devs will probably get forced off here for Gom. If he doesn't retreat them, they will go down, but he does retreat them in time. Dark Reaper is going to be repurchasing the Dark Reaper Exarch as well. Definitely a good upgrade. Which is very unfortunate that he lost it earlier with that single P-Dev shot, which really done a number. They are heavy infantry and do take bonus damage from that kind of thing. They're a very nice grenade here. Nearly a little bit too late for Gom there. Lily took a lot of damage, but did manage to retreat at the absolute last second though. Caden Kaskin's going to be throwing a grenade onto the Ogryn's, going to be knocking them down, doing a lot of damage to them as well at the same time. Also an undetected webway gate there at the very top left. Another Manticore going to be coming out for Adila. Meanwhile, the Lehman Russ now coming mid, a nice bright orange Lehman Russ coming mid here for Reacts, but still no Lord Commissar. In a very difficult spot for that Terminator Force Commander to actually get res. I'm sure he could actually do it. He does actually have the teleports pack built in. Could teleport over this little cliff here and actually get a res onto the Commissar. But Aleman going in very aggressive here. Avatar is now out in the field, going to be providing a lot of buffs here to Adeptus' army. Meanwhile, the Ogryn's taking a lot of damage, going to get forced off here. The triple or double Guardsman and Kassakin blob with plasma guns going to be a bit too much there for the Ogryn's. The Lord Commissar has also been replaced himself, but he's taking so much damage as a forced retreat almost instantly here. The Lehman go going to take some rear armor hits from that avatar, and a Manticore strike is also going to go down, but it's actually going to miss as everything has now retreated away here for red team. But red team coming back in once again. Lehman is reversing into combat, wants to show off that rear armor. Put some more Terminators here for Gomes. This time a Terminator Assault, just a Terminator Squad to go with his Terminator Force Commander. Double Assault Cannons, that's an insane amount of piercing damage. Assault Cannon giving 60 piercing DPS per Assault Terminator model. Giving the squad in total 120 and plus the Terminator Force Command, that's 180 piercing DPS. Extremely effective against Adila's composition here of purely infantry. And those P-Devs as well, being very effective with the AoE knockback. Scout's going to be coming in here, infiltrated. Lehman Russ is going to be charging in here. Grenade does get thrown by the Kaskins, but does actually miss. Kaskins now forced to retreat away. Warp Throw is activated here. Might catch out the Commissar. Will catch out the Commissar, in fact. And Commissar will be free to do what he wants still. And Manticore could be in risk of dying here, as the Ogrins are going to be pushing in even further forward. I think the Manticore has now been spotted. The Commissar getting caught out there by the Avatar. Avatar is going to be fighting the Ogrins now. Ogrins trying to ignore them, trying to focus down these guardsmen instead. Manticore Strike is also going to go down in mid. Manticore Strike will miss, however, the guardsmen are retreating away. Wailing Doom though. Terminators do teleport out of there. Terminator Force Commander also teleporting out of there as well. And the Avatar in a little bit of trouble now. Going to be taking a lot of damage here, but should actually be fine overall. He is super heavy infantry, and there isn't really much in mid in terms of countering it. The Avatar down to 2,700 health. If the Avatar sits here and fights, it will lose to these Ogrins. Terminator's even going to go in and force a melee here as well. The heavy melee more effective than the piercing damage that they're actually outputting right now. Meanwhile, Dire Avengers going to go down here, trying to get a desperate cap onto the natural VP. 104 VPs to 274. Warlock going to be jumping in, going to be knocking back all those melee units for the Emperor used onto these Terminators here. I think for the Emperor could have got used onto these Ogrins here when they were chasing much earlier, because I believe you can put 40 Emperor on allied units, and those Ogres with 25% damage boost can have really done quite a number onto that Avatar as well. Meanwhile, Adila going to be pushing in towards mid. Terminator Force Commander already on the scene, P-Devs already on the scene as well, some Tactical Marines and Stern Guard Veterans. The Last Cannon is also set up as a counter as well to that Avatar and towards any vehicles on the map. See a counter game purchase here by Adeptus, and a very nice rocket run here from Adila once again. Going to be shoving all these units into this little corner here, but the squads overall will live. AP dev squad did go down for Gom. That Lehman Russ though, very aggressive, is going to be going down. Flare is dropped, very nice use of the flare, and Terminator is going to be forcing melee here onto these heavy weapons team. Manticore Strike is going to be going down, but the Manticore Strike is going to miss for the most part. Even the grenade getting thrown, I really want this Lehman dead, but that Lehman is refusing to die at this point, and Lehman will be able to get out of here alive. And the second Lehman has now hit the field as well. Could be time for a repair bunker, but there's still two guardsmen, one guardsman per Lehman to actually support it. The Dark Reapers taking so much damage here, even though they are heavy infantry, they are still not that tanky and will easily go down to the amount of piercing damage laid out by these Terminators, especially when they have 40 Emperor on them as well. And this Vanquisher turret is also going to be short-lived as well, doing some decent damage to that Lehman, but he's also going to get fisted by these Terminators at the same time. And the Avatar coming in, this time Seer Council supports them. These Terminators might not be so lucky. If they have their teleport and cooldown, they will definitely go down. The Avatar going to be giving a damage boost as well to the Seer Council, and the Avatar and Seer Council combined means that they take reduced range damage in total as well. The Seer Council really wants him to go in for these Terminators. Lehman is forced to back off towards Gom. One Terminator model down. Scouts also going to go down. Wailing Doom going to hit these Devastators as well. Nearly wiping these Devastators down to just 28 HP. Seer Council now jumping onto that Terminator Force Commander as well. And Seer Council going to be taking a lot of damage. That Lehman's also doing a decent amount of splash damage, but also does splash damage to friendly units as well. But the Seer Council able to get away though with full models, and will be in base regen as well. And Adila's Plasma Guardsmen are going to be destroying these regular Guardsmen, just because there are more Guardsmen in total for Adila. But the Lehman coming in here with the Vanquisher. Not the Vanquisher, the Executioner, is going to be doing some really nice AoE damage, and Adila is forced away. Meanwhile, the Commissar to the left-hand side is going to be capping, and Dire Avenger is also going to be capping as well, so they're going to be trading VPs either side. But Gom going to be coming in into that right-hand side, and Adila could execute his Guardsmen here and turn around and fight these Ogrins. The Ogrins are going to retreat away instead. Adeptus is going to use the Webway Gate to actually capture that left-hand VP instead, but Dire Avenger is going to be going down once again. Distortion Cannon has also been purchased here for him as well, and Dark Reapers are still in the area as well. But Lord General going to be coming in to get a res onto that Warlock though. And that will bring him up to level 9. Wow, he's actually really leveled in fact. No armor on Lord General though. I think some armor could work out really nicely here. And heavy weapons team has just come in once again for Adila. Did lose the previous heavy weapons team that was upgraded with a last cannon. Could upgrade this one to an auto cannon. In fact, he's upgrading it to a last cannon once again. Probably the best choice given that there are two Lemans on the field. The City Council taking a lot of damage here. Going to be forced away. The Lemans not really doing too much on retreats, but doing a lot of damage when the City Council wasn't retreating away. And Gom going to be pushing in mid himself, has got a plasma gun on his tactical marine, is going to be very effective against the Avatar. The triple plasmas upgrades here for Adila, going to be destroying these tactical marines, forced to retreat after a single salvo. And Singularity is going to be going down here. The Avatar has given vision and some units will get caught out in that Singularity, but overall it won't matter too much. But the Dark Reapers on this right hand side going to be forced back, and Gom's actually replaced the scouts, in fact fully upgraded them as well with the shotguns and the sergeant as well. You can see that they are level 1, so they are fresh. And the Lord Commissar is going to go down, looked like he was armed there with the Fist of Brockus as well. But Nunchar Fall does not work on that Lord Commissar. Lehman is path blocking Guardsman. Guardsman also path blocking the Lehman as well. Last cannon is also slain, but Lehman will be able to get out there alive. And Terminator is going to be pushing in, but the Seer Count is going to be coming in here for Adeptus. Avatar still in the area as well. And the Seer Count is going to be jumping in onto those ranged Terminators. Terminator Force Commander going to force away that distortion cannon. Guardsman going to get warp thrown here by the Warlock. Going to get thrown off the VP, in fact. 62 VP is 224. We're seeing very low on VPs right now. The double Lehman's going to be pushing in here. Red team look like they're in a very dominant position. It's about to be a 2-0 cap, or 2-1 cap for them right now. Wailing Doom going to go off. Avatar is going to go down here, in fact. Guardsmen are coming in here. The Ogrins will get forced off, but the Avatar loss is going to be huge, though. And the Ogrins are taking so much damage here, but the Ogrins really need to back away. The Ogrins are going to lose their bonehead here before backing away. Terminators and the Standguard veterans also going to be taking a lot of damage from all the amounts of plasma damage that Adila is able to put out. But that's going to be a dead Guardsman squad though. That Lehman though, with the AoE shots, going to be a bit too much there. Warlock, Seer Council exiting the structure once again, going to be jumping into the fight. But They Shall Know No Fear is getting used on the Standguard, so Reen needs to not focus them down because they do have that 50% special chance, although the Seer Council are able to knock them over apparently. Going to be jumping onto those Terminators instead. Warlock is also in the area, and the Kaskans are trying to jump in as well with their plasma guns. Do also have the anti-vehicle grenade, the crack grenade, which they could also use, which they do use onto the Lehman there, but there's nothing to actually follow that up just yet. But those assault Terminators, or those regular Terminators, sorry, are going to be going down. Seer Council are going to retreat away after killing them as well. Meanwhile, on the right hand side, Dark Reapers taking a lot of damage here from these fully upgraded scouts of Gom. Lehman's still alive, needs to be careful not to overextend because the last cannon is set up in mid, and that sniper rifle can buff that last cannon, giving it extra range. So the Guardsmen are now in the area to repair. Dark Reapers really trying to cap this as well, but going to be unsuccessful. But Blue Team going to be on a 2-1 cap right now as they're able to resecure mid, and Lehman's just need some repairs right now. Autocannon and D, oh no, well, autocannon, last cannon and D cannon set up in mid. P-Dev's going to get purchased here for Gom. He has so much power right now, he could actually buy anything that he wants really. 900 or 500 power stocked up, and spending 400 requisition on P-Devs. I think that maybe could have gone for something else instead, perhaps a Land Raider Redeemer. The scouts going to try and cap him, but the scouts will get seen, or should get seen. An Orbital Bombardment is also going to go down. He's actually going to use a red on that instead. Going to be catching out that last cannon, going to be catching out the D cannon, and going to try and catch out that VP. But I should catch out Lord General instead. D cannon is going to go down. Heavy weapons team is also going to be going down. Lord General going to be taking a lot of damage. Ogryn is trying to come in for a flank, but a very nice grenade here is actually good. In fact, that Ogryn squad is going to get wiped here. The two grenades from the two Castlekin squads is going to be a bit too much. Lord General himself, though, very low. Lehmans are pushing in once again. The Seer Council really needs to stop being so grouped up, but Fire Dragon's going to be coming out, going to try and fight those Lehman. Seer Council can easily jump onto the Guardsman here, but the Seer Council is still stuck in range stance for whatever reason. The Fire Dragons need to focus down the Lehmans instead focusing down the Guardsman. Warp Throw is going to go down, but will miss because the unit starts to retreat away in time. Stern Guards and Tactical Marines coming in. Guardsman getting very low here. Fire Dragons are now forced away. No AV currently for Adila or Adeptus other than the Fire Dragons, which were just forced off. A second heavy weapons team is getting purchased, going to be upgraded to a last cannon as well, but that's not going to be here for a few more seconds, and two lemurs are going to have a free reign of everything in mid. The warlock is coming into the area. All these guardsmen, Castigans, so grouped up, going to be taking so much damage here from this lemur with the executioner, and the entire army here of Adila is forced to back away. Providence is used here with the merciless witchblade. Going to be running somewhere, going to be running after these p-devs instead, going to be landing a special against them as well. Should be able to take down a couple of models with that witchblade. It does do 130 damage per hit, and the warlock is also leveled as well, so it's actually going to be slightly high destructor onto the scouts as well. The shotgun blast is going to fail there as the warlock does retreat away in time, otherwise he may have gone down. Right hand side, Dark Reapers seem to be the capping choice here for Adeptus. Lord Jiren was also going to be capping choice in mid, down to 43 VPs. Blue team, Seer Council, Fire Dragon is going to be exiting gate here, and blue team now on a 1-0 cap. Last Cannon is on its way towards mid. The two Lehman Russers still wreaking absolute havoc though. For the Emperor Grenade is getting thrown onto these Dark Reapers, going to lose two models here, and Scouts are going to recap that VP. Somehow Scouts are still level 1, even though they've actually done a lot of solo killing here onto this right hand side against these Dark Reapers with their grenades and shotguns. A Terminator Force Commander going to be here in mid, going to be taking a lot of range damage though. Guardsman getting supported by that Aura of Discipline, and Fist of Brockus might be time to actually switch to the Stubbornness in fact. And Terminator Force Commander is going to be teleporting and retreating away. The Guardsman also going to get forced away in mid, could always execute the Guardsman though since they both have the Commissar upgrade. The Lord Commissar himself could always execute with that Bionic Eye. But Seer Count's going to be jumping into combat here. Shotgun Blast going to be knocking them back. Fire Dragons also getting knocked back by the PDF since it is ability knockback. Another Rocket Run here though for Adila. So many Rocket Runs this game. Wow! That Rocket Run has really, really destroyed him. Just down to Tactical Marines and Stern Guard Veterans now, losing both of his setup teams. Also still with his Terminator Force Commander as well, but the Crack Grenade is going to get thrown down onto the Lehman Russ, but the Last Cannon is forced to reset up since it's at an awkward angle, but Flare is dropped down at the same time, preventing the Last Cannon from being able to fire at this other Lehman Russ, which is nearly level 4 as well. One or two more Guardsman kills and it will be at level 4 in fact. But Gom though, losing so much in that Rocket Run, down to just this essentially. Does actually nearly have enough requisition in fact for Terminators, but doesn't actually have enough red for them. But Gom does need a new unit out fairly soon. In fact, is actually arming himself with a Power Fist. No. Can't arm himself with a Power Fist. When he's in Terminator form. I'm a bit confused about that. We'll see. But mine's going to get dropped onto the army here. There is no detection in mid whatsoever. Manticore Strike is also going to go down, going to be catching out of Seer Council, and those Fire Dragons going to be detonating all these mines. Very nice combination attempt there. But Singularity is going to be going down along with a Warp Throw as well, but he's just Warp Throwing all the units out of the Singularity. So I think he should have maybe left that Warp Throw as it was, but that Lehman though getting so low, Fire Dragons could exit the structure once again if they're available, and they will. And that Lehman gained so low, but the Singularity missing though. The D-Cannon itself is still doing a lot of work. Seer Council needs to actually jump into combat. They're not jumping into combat just yet, but these Guardsmen are getting absolutely thrashed right now for a React, and he will lose two Guardsmen squad. In fact, the Lehmans are low enough that the Lehmans could actually go down to the Seer Council here. They do 200 power melee DPS, which is not most effective against vehicles, but because they have so much power melee DPS, they're actually going to be enough, especially when they're getting rear armor hits. Going to be chasing down this Lehman Russ. Last Cannon is setting up and is going to get rear armor hit onto that secondary Lehman Russ. Reacts is actually going to lose everything in this push here. Red team down to 69 VPs. Seer Council is going to half block that secondary Lehman Russ. It is going to go down to the Last Cannon, and the Terminator Force Command is trying to cap, and Red team actually concede the game. They've just lost so much, especially due to that one Rocket Run down here from Adila. Red team losing everything, and Reacts losing everything in that single push towards the end, losing both the Lehmans, losing both the Guardsmen as well, and Blue team going to be able to pull it through when they were at a VP deficit, and were still at a VP deficit in fact.